The Sabbath was passed on the first day of the week. Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices that they might come and anoint him. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it. His countenance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. And the guards shook for fear of him, and they became like dead men.
Mary Magdalene went to the tomb early, while it was still dark, and saw that the stone had been taken away from the tomb. Then she ran and came to Simon Peter and to the other disciple, whom Jesus loved, and said to them,
"They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him."
As light began to dawn very early in the morning, the other Mary and Salome and certain other women with them came to see the tomb,
bringing the spices which they had prepared. They came to the tomb when the sun had risen, and they said among themselves,
"Who will roll away the stone from the door of the tomb for us?"
But when they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away from the tomb, for it was very large.
Then they went in, and entering the tomb, did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. And it happened, as they were greatly perplexed about this, that behold, two men stood by them in shining garments.
They were alarmed and afraid, and bowed their faces to the earth. But one of the angels, a young man, clothed in a long white robe, sitting on the right side, answered and said to the women,
"Do not be afraid. For I know that you seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come, see the place where they laid the Lord. But go quickly and tell his disciples and Peter that he is risen from the dead, and indeed he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him, as he said to you. Behold, I have told you."
They said to him further,
"Remember how he spoke to you when he was still in Galilee, saying, 'The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and the third day rise again.'"
And they remembered his words.
So they went out quickly and fled from the tomb, for they trembled with fear and great joy and were amazed. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid, but ran to bring his disciples word.
And hearing from Mary Magdalene, Peter therefore arose and went out, and the other disciple, and were going to the tomb.
So they both ran together, and the other disciple outran Peter and came to the tomb first.
And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes laying there, yet he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. And he saw the linen clothes laying there by themselves, and the handkerchief that had been around his head, not lying with the linen cloths, but folded together in a place by itself.
Then the other disciple, who came to the tomb first, went in also. And he saw, and he believed.
For as yet they did not know the scripture, that he must rise again from the dead.
Then the disciples departed and went away again to their own homes, marveling to themselves at what had happened. Mary stood outside the tomb weeping, and as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the tomb.
And she saw two angels in white sitting, one at the head and the other at the feet where the body of Jesus had lain. Then they said to her,
"Woman, why are you weeping?"
She said to them,
"Because they have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him."
Now when she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, and did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her,
"Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you seeking?"
She, supposing him to be the gardener, said to him,
"Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away."
Jesus said to her,
"Mary."
She turned and said to him,
"Rabboni,"
which is to say, teacher. Jesus said to her,
"Do not cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God.'"
Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord and that he had spoken these things to her. "Now I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse.
And he who sat on it was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and makes war.
His eyes were like a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns.
He had a name written that no one knew except himself.
He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God.
He himself will rule with a rod of iron.
Now out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, that with it he should strike the nations.
And he himself will rule with a rod of iron.
He himself treads the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God.
And he has on his robe and his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
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 King of Kings and Lord of Lords.